We are under the lights as the show gets you ready for another edition of Major League Baseball. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the Washington Nationals and the Miami Marlins. The speedy Trey Turner digs in now, and we are set for baseball here this evening. The 2-2. 73 degrees, our game time temperature here tonight, and it probably won't get a whole lot cooler than that. Slider, strike three called as the leadoff man is set down looking to open up the ball game. In now is Adam Eaton, and he's definitely off to a fast start in the early part of the season. And a half-hearted attempt that time as he broke the plane of the plate. It's a ball and two strikes now. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Joyce is right there, and there's the second out of the inning. Here's Howie Kendrick. He drove in one of their two runs in last night's ball game. Now the 1-1 pitch. A bouncer up the middle, and that finds its way through for a base hit.
The left fielder, number 22.
To the plate now, Juan Soto. Two balls and a strike.
2-1.
Maybe a little jumpy there as he swings through the fastball. Fouled off. The 2-2 one more time. Lifted the other way down the left field line. And that will end up a foul ball. That's lifted the other way out to left. Dickerson's there. And that's the third out. Now batting, Jonathan Villar. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-2. Doesn't catch the outside corner. It's a ball. Line down the left field line. But this will be foul. Is put in play to the right side of the infield. He's got a hurry, and an off balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow. Up next from Miami, Miguel Rojas. He'll get to take his first cuts here. A 2-2 count. Here's the pitch. Grounded back up the middle. And there's out number two. Digging in, Corey Dickerson took an 0-for-4 in the victory last night. 1-1.
Ball. Two balls, one strike.
Sinker misses there, and now he's in trouble. 3-1.
This is a good at bat so far here with two away. If you're going to go down 1-2-3, at least make the guy work for it.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. Striding in now for the Nats, Eric Thames, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. The 1-1. Hit back up the middle. And this will find its way into center field for a leadoff single.
The catcher, number 28.
So now to the plate, Kurt Suzuki. No contact there, and it's 1-2. Ripped down the first base line, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2.
He was looking for a swing and a miss breaker right there, but left that one in the zone that got fouled off.
And that is swung on and missed by Suzuki. He's down on strikes for the first down.
The third baseman, number
Thames, leads off first with one away.
Cabrera.
Has dribbled Cabrera ahead in a 3-1 count now. Due next, there's Ryan Zimmerman. And it's fouled away. Swing and a miss on the breaking pitch. Two away. Here's Ryan Zimmerman now. He drove in the other of their two runs last night. One and one. Here it is.
Hey, struggling to find the release point of that curveball. That wasn't a very good one. Somehow he's just got to find that feel because that's a pitch he's going to need going forward.
Now the 2-1 is taken. Ball three.
I'd be real surprised if he goes back out away there on the mound. This is a count for a fastball challenge, and we'll see if he's ready for it in the box.
Hit high and deep to right center. Right fielder giving chase. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. Last half of the second set to go, and that'll bring in Garrett Cooper. He's ready for his first at-bat of this early season contest. On the ground to third. And a flip to first from Cabrera in time for the first out. At the plate, Brian Anderson. It was a two-hit effort for him, including a home run in last night's game. One and two now as that one's fouled off. The pitch.
Ball.
Bottom of the second here with no score.
Two strikes.
Bouncer up the middle. And there are two away now. Here's Matt Joyce now. Lifetime against Joe Ross. He's hitless in three at-bats. Fly ball to straightaway left. Soto is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. And now for Washington, Joe Ross, 9-1-2 due up. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. 1-2 now as that's in there at the knees.
12, 1-2.
Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out.
The batter, number 7.
So striding forward now, Trey Turner, 0-for-1 here in the early going. 2-1 the count to Trey Turner.
2-1.
Line to second where it's caught there for out number two. Adam Eaton digging in next. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Third inning, no score to this point. Got him to go after a bad one there, and it evens the count at 2-2.
Threw that fastball right by him. He had no chance to get the barrel to that one.
Liner towards second, and that is through into right field for a single.
Now back, the second baseman, Howie.
Stepping in now, Howie Kendrick. Strike taken, the throw is not close as he's in there with a stolen base. And 2-2. Cutter, and it doesn't make it back. 3-2.
If you're at the plate right now, you have to realize who's on deck. I guarantee you something's over the heart of the plate. You have to be aggressive in the zone right here.
Too high, and that cost him ball four.
The left fielder, number 22, Juan Soto.
The set and the 1-1.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
2-1. Here it is. Curveball bounces, and this one gets away. So now two men in scoring position. Two and two. Here it is. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Joyce is there. He's got it, and that'll get him out of the jam. Ready now for the Marlins, Harold Ramirez. He'll match up now with Joe Ross to lead off the inning. The 2-2. Is swung on and missed. He got him. So one out now for the Marlins in their half of the third. And up next will be the big catcher, Jorge Alfaro. Line to the right side. And the Marlins had their first hit of the game. At the plate now, Jordan Yamamoto. And they'll try to stay out of the double play here as he lays this one down. On to the pitcher covering it first, and it's your textbook 3-6-1 double play that'll get him out of the inning. Digging in, Eric Thames, a base hit in his first trip.
This game is rolling right along as we move into the middle innings with no score. You'd think by now one of these two teams.
It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. And that nearly broke our tie, but instead it's a foul ball. Boy, good cutting action to that pitch as that's the first out of the inning. So one away here with the bases empty. And that'll bring in the catcher, Kurt Suzuki. Chopped toward the second baseman. Right to him. On to first, and Suzuki's retired. Two away. So two are gone now in the Nationals' fourth. And that'll bring in the switch hitting former All-Star is Drubal Cabrera. 1-1 pitch coming now to Cabrera. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Two balls, one strike.
Just off the outside that time. Laid off for a ball. The 3-1 pitch. Got him looking, and that ends the inning. Back to the top of the order now, and the switch hitter Jonathan Villar will be the next to bat. And he takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone. Standing in, Miguel Rojas. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Yeah, Matty, and it looked like a sinker in his last AB that got him to roll over. Kind of similar situation right here. Similar stuff on the mound. Look for them to try and get him to do exactly the same thing as his last AB. He's got to fight to get it elevated just a little bit more.
Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. And, oh, he missed a home run by a matter of feet. It's off the wall. And now he'll get into scoring position with two away.
Up next for the Marlins, the first baseman, Garrett Cooper.
Into the box now, Garrett Cooper. Up and in on the hands. It's two balls and a strike. Line toward center field, and he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. Digging in for his second at bat, Ryan Zimmerman flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Swing and a miss, and he'll start the fifth the same way he ended the fourth, with a punch out, one away.
The pitcher, number 41.
Into the box now, the Nationals pitcher, Joe Ross, comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. 1 and 2 to the Nationals pitcher. Turned on, but that's ripped foul down the third baseline. Here's the 1 and 2 delivery. This is on the ground over to first. He's got it, and he'll flip it to the pitcher covering for the out. So the lineup flips over, and digging in, Trey Turner hit the ball pretty well in his last at bat, but it resulted in a line out.
Yeah, Matty, but as he walks to the plate right here, he feels good building off that last AB. He hit that ball on screws. Got to take advantage of that pitch right there. 0-2 breaker hanging over the heart of the plate. Not going to see too many of those today.
Count even at 2-2. Skied into straightaway right. Ramirez is under it, and he makes the catch for out number 3. In now, Brian Anderson, as we move past the halfway point in this one and begin the bottom of the fifth. Swing and a liner, but this is gloved over there at first as he was in the right spot at the right time. One away. Into the box, Matt Joyce. He's 0 for 1 thus far. Here's the 1 and 2 delivery. As anticipated, here's a ground ball now to the right side. Throw in time at first for out number 2. Digging in now, Harold Ramirez, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Thames is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Top half of the sixth about to get started. Stepping into the box, Adam Eaton. A hit and 2 at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. And the slider is low and inside as he just about got him there. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Waiting on deck is Howie Kendrick. Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball 4, so the leadoff hitter is aboard to start the sixth. So a runner at first now with nobody out. And stepping in is the second baseman, Howie Kendrick. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Chasing after it is Joyce. He's there and records the first down. So a runner at first now with one away, and digging into bat next, the ever dangerous Juan Soto. The 1-1. A bullet to first base. And they will apply the tag between first and second. It's a double play, and just like that, the side is retired. Ready for another chance? Jorge Alfaro, 1-for-1 after a single his first time up. And a curveball's by him that time as he falls behind now, 1-2.
Offered at that breaking ball below the zone, and that's a tough one to spit on. But the key is recognizing it coming out of the pitcher's hand earlier, making sure that it goes up before it comes down. More likely to be a hanger when that's the case.
Coming to the plate now, the pitcher for the Marlins, Jordan Yamamoto. The 1-1. Waves and misses for strike number 2.
One ball, 2 strikes.
And here's a ball lifted back toward the stands in right, so we'll try it again at 1-2. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Good bite to that sinker as he gets him to swing through it for out number 2. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Jonathan Villar. He's 0 for 2 thus far in this one. Hit down the line at first. Zimmerman has it, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Seventh inning ready to roll. Now at the plate, Eric Thames. He went down on strikes last time up.
Not sure if this is a powerhouse pitching performance by both teams or bad hitting, but as we're moving late into this one, it's about time somebody put something together to try to score a run.
And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number seven. Digging in once again, Kurt Suzuki. Third trip to the plate for him here. He struck out and grounded out in his first two tries. And that fastball is too much for him there. 1-2.
Hey, it's a game of execution. If the pitcher stays right there, this lineup's going to continue to have a tough time.
But this will hang up just enough as he takes it in stride in left center for the second out. Now digging in, the switch hitter, Asdrubal Cabrera. No hits to this point. No runs, three hits, and no errors so far for the Nationals. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Now a fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at 2-2. Lifted the other way down the left field line. After it is Dickerson. But he can't get there, and it bounces over the wall. It's a ground rule double. Sterling Sharp will get the ball here as he looks to get the final out in the top of the seventh. Standing in now, Ryan Zimmerman. Two balls and two strikes, the count to Ryan Zimmerman. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. Coming to the plate now, Miguel Rojas. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far.
Starting to run out of time. They haven't been able to score any runs as we're moving late into this one. A perfect time for this leadoff guy to try to get on base and ignite a rally. That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2, but when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one. Three. Corey. Dickerson.
Line drive to center field. Eaton is right there, one down. So here's the cleanup hitter for Miami, Garrett Cooper. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far.
Cooper.
Now the 1-1 pitch is in there for the second strike.
His slider's been impressive all night long. If he can continue spinning it like that, he's going to be just fine.
Weak grounder down the first baseline to second for one. Return throw is in time. How about that? They do turn two, and it gets him out of the inning. Starlin Castro is going to be asked to get things going here as a lead off the top of the eighth.
Number 14, Starlin Castro.
Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. A swing and a miss on a ball way out of the zone, and there's one away. So the Nats lineup turns over, and to the plate, Trey Turner. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside. He did well to get a piece that time, and it'll stay 2-2. Pitch on the way. Smoke toward third. And the throw will get him at first as he is robbed on a magnificent play there. So two down now in the Washington eighth. And the next to bat is speedy Adam Eaton. Tried to bunt his way on base here, but this will roll foul. The 1-2. Hot shot down the line. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Ground ball right side. On to first, and this will remain a tie ball game as the inning is over. Austin Voth will come on and make his fourth appearance in this campaign.
Number 50.
So coming to the plate, Brian Anderson. He lined out in his last trip, so looking for better fortunes here. The 1-1 home. And here's a ball hit in the air. Right fielder giving chase, and no one will track it down. And he fouls this one off. Tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2.
Tough to take a pitch like that right there, especially in a 1-2 count. You almost get in that auto swing mode. Great job to work the count back to even.
And he struck him out. Now in the box, Matt Joyce. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen. Hitters count now, the 2-1. Weak grounder back to the mound. And eight innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. Yimi Garcia will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. John Birdie is into the ballgame as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch.
Number 5, John Birdie.
On a good pitch there, had him stretching to get out there, and it's 2-2 now. A swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here in the ninth. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Juan Soto. He was a double play victim last time around. Here now the 2-2. Oh, and look at this. High in the air and deep. And when this ball comes down, they'll have taken the lead. Home run. At the plate, Eric Thames. There's ball four. Striding in, Kurt Suzuki. Hit the ball pretty well in his last at-bat, but it resulted in a line-out.
Yeah, he hit it hard. That's all you can ask. You can't control the result sometimes, Matty. Just unlucky with the placement.
Now a swing and a miss here by Suzuki as he set down on strikes for the second out. Digging in and looking for more as Drubel Cabrera. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Struck him out, so it remains a one-run lead as they head in for their final set of swing. Sean Doolittle takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door.
Now pitching and batting in the sixth spot.
Digging in to try it again, Jorge Alfaro. He's singled in two trips to the plate thus far.
Batting 9. Number 10, Yan Jones.
Swing and a ground ball to third. And a flip to first from Cabrera in time for the first down. So stepping in, John Birdie. This is foul right side. Bases are empty, one man out. There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. Around first, digging for two. A leap, but he can't rein it in. It's off the wall. And he's out at third. Might have gotten a little greedy that time. So now to the plate, Jonathan Villar. Good pitch as this is swung on and missed, and now they're down to perhaps their final strike of the evening. Miami down to their last strike. Two balls and two strikes to Jonathan Villar. One strike from a shutout. Here it comes. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Eaton is under it. Makes the catch, and that's the ball game.
Wow, that's a rarity. A 1-0 game in baseball these days. Both of these pitchers pitched awfully well. It's a shame one of them had to lose this game.
And that one run held up tonight, 1-0 the final. The Nats came through when it mattered in the ninth on the way to the win. Austin Voth claims the win out of the pen, his first. Sean Doolittle earns the save out of the bullpen, his first of the year. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
The final line score for the ball game tonight: for the victorious Washington Nationals, one run, five hits, no errors. They left seven men on base. For the Marlins, no run, three hits, no errors. They left three men on base. Time of the ball game: a swift 2 hours and 19 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely.